In November 2015, the United People's Movement made promises to the Baster communities of both Rehoboth and Okahandja regarding their stake in the urban and rural land debate, and the UPM has since been delivering. The UPM's efforts to bring reform to supposedly corrupt Rehoboth Town Council has led to an investigation into the matter by Minister of Urban and Rural Development, Sophia Shaningwa. With us in studio to talk about the party's efforts to bring solid service delivery to the people of Rehoboth, as well as the party's mandate and challenges, is Jan van Wyk from the United People's Movement. Good evening, viewers, and welcome to One Exclusive. Now, tonight is the second last part of our political party series. We have interviewed all the opposition parties that has representation in Parliament. With us this evening is the UPM, and hopefully next week we will hear from the ruling party, SWAPO. Good evening, Mr. van Wyk, and welcome to One Exclusive.
Good evening, and thank you.
Thank you very much for joining us. Now, let's get right into it. In November 2016, Minister Sophia Shaningwa told the Rehoboth Council to clean up its act. And that happened after one of your members, Lenny Pinar, reached out to the media to tell the media about the tension that's existing there. Let's talk about that tension.
Yeah, thank you very much for the opportunity. The UPM currently is three members on the Rehoboth Town Council. Reverend Lenny Pinar, then Ms. Marita Pickering, and also Ms. Emma Farmer. They were elected in 2015, so they just made a year end of last year. Now, the Rehoboth Town Council does have a history of corruption and corrupt practices. And we have tried several times to get the intervention of the minister, or the ministers even before the current minister, to see how they can intervene to ask the council to clean up the mess. Independent forensic auditors indicated that a lot of millions went missing between 2005-2009. And this findings was also confirmed by the Office of the Auditor General during the normal audit process. During 2011-12, we tried everything possible to bring these problems out to the relevant authorities. We went as far as making a case with the commercial branch of the Namibian police. We involved the Anti-Corruption Commission, but nothing happened.
So I just want to, for clarity's sake, these will then be the three members that are currently on the Rehoboth Town Council. They are looking for reform from within the council.
Yeah.
All right, fantastic. Yeah.
So with the increase in our representation on the Rehoboth Town Council from 2015, yes, things started to get better. Yes. But as soon as the councillor started to address the issues of concern within council, they actually get the indication that no, we are the majority. The SWAPO is the majority, and they will not listen to what we are saying. They even don't want to listen to very good inputs from the opposition. So they went further by conducting closed-door meetings, only the SWAPO councillors. Now, when we started, our council started to address these issues, the relationship actually became so bad that officials started to insult UPM councillors. Late last year, during December last year, one of the officials damaged a vehicle of one of the opposition councillors. When she tried to confront him about it, he tried to attack her. So the situation is quite bad, and that's why we also came up with a petition earlier this year. We petitioned the minister to come to intervene. We pointed out some of the problems that was identified, and we submitted just over 2,000 signatures on the petition. Now, the current investigations into the affairs of the Rehoboth Town Council was concluded on the 17th of this month. Okay. And the minister has promised that as soon as the report is finalized, she will avail a report to the public. So we are waiting for that. And hopefully this time around, something will happen. Brilliant. Because we are really tired, and the residents, the ratepayers, they are fed up. Mm. Yeah.
The land debate has stretched to all corners of the country. First on the scene was the affirmative repositioning movement, who sought to pressurize government into making urban land available to landless Windhoek residents. Earlier this year, the Landless People's Movement started making headlines, instigating protests over government's inability to swiftly resettle those who lay claim on ancestral land. The LPM held demonstrations in Grootfontein and Windhoek, and soon the movement led to protests in Rehoboth. The United People's Movement has been attempting to make urban land in the Rehoboth area available to landless people over the last 2 years. With us in studio to talk about the Landless People's Movement in Rehoboth and other areas of Namibia is Mr. Jan van Wyk from the UPM.
Now, if we're talking about the UPM representing Rehoboth, the other pressing issue there is obviously land. There were protests last year. The affirmative repositioning movement even, you know, showed up there and they had made a presence aware. So what is the UPM's stance on the land issue?
Yeah, with regard to land, the UPM has a mandate to fight for the poor and the low-income groups when it comes to land. There is a huge need for affordable urban land in this country. And the United People's Movement as a political party will make use of all the processes to see how we can address the issue. At one stage, we were actually forced to involve ourselves in meetings to see how we can convince people to not result into land grabbing. But it's quite difficult because people are waiting for some time now, and the authorities are just dragging their feet. With regard to the land issue in Rehoboth, we know that in 1992, there was a cabinet resolution that land should be available to certain people.
Yes.
Up to now, nothing has happened. So we have
Sorry to interrupt you, is this ancestral land or is this simply, you know, communal farms that would then be split up and stuff like that?
No, this is urban land.
Urban land.
Yeah, urban land. So that decision was taken and we started in 2011 using the normal channels to make authorities aware that there is a need to implement this report, but nothing has happened. And we are saying that we need government to avail land, not only in Rehoboth. On our records now, right now, we are having about 7,000 people in Rehoboth that is in urgent need of land. In Okahandja, for example, we are sitting with 2,700 people who are in need of urban land. And these people are not from, they are from the poor and low-income groups. So what we are saying is that local authorities across the country should avail affordable land to the poor and the low-income groups. They should implement schemes to make it possible for the poor people and the low-income people to acquire land.
Would that be housing as well, I'm presuming?
That will be housing if housing is available.
Yes.
But for now, we are looking at land, at least if we can have a piece of land to put up your shack for now. Although we don't promote the shacks in the country, if we can have a permanent structure, that will be good. But to start off, you need to start somewhere. And it will also help communities to get families together. Because right now you are having cases whereby the mother is squatting in the backyard of someone with the kids while the father is somewhere trying to work to make a living. So that is with regard to urban land. Urban land is very expensive due to various reasons, but we know that there are some ways to bring down the price of land, and we want government to look at that. With regard to land, commercial land, the United People's Movement was one of the parties that opposes the land bill, because in the current form, it's not to the benefit of all. No consultations were done, although the government claims that consultations were done, that was not done. So we want government to relook at the land bill. And that's why we said that let's wait for the land conference. We have also indicated that the current resettlement program has failed the nation. And the government will have to revisit the program and come up with totally different strategies to implement it and to make sure that the targeted people, the people who are really in need of land, is resettled. I did ask the minister in parliament to define the word resettlement, because it seems that there is a misunderstanding when it comes to the word resettlement. What does it mean? So that is the stand of the UPM on the land issue.
Will we see the UPM supporting fragment, groups like the Landless People's Movement?
The UPM as a political party will not interfere with other organizations. Okay. From the side of the UPM, we also had a press release on how we see the situation. And I personally view my support for this group. But the United People's Movement as a party, as I've said, will not interfere. We'll monitor the situation, and when necessary, we'll do
step
up.
Fantastic. Yeah. The other topic that's been hot on everyone's tongues is that of tribalism, particularly between different parties, split between different ethnic lines. I mean, you guys don't make, a show of it. You say, yes, we are representing the Baster community. So how do you feel about tribalism then?
I'm not quite aware of tension between opposition parties with regard to tribes. We know that, for example, the United People's Movement, we draw our support from the Rehoboth Basters, while, for example, Nudo get its support from the Owereros, and Mach from the white people. So the opposition parties currently, some of them do have a basis to work from. As I have said, I'm not aware of any tension between opposition parties. There might be some tension between opposition parties and the ruling party, during normal times, we don't see it. It's only when you go into elections that you'll see this infights.
Now let's talk about the UPM's challenges. What are the biggest challenges you face at the moment?
Yeah, challenges will always be there. I think right now our biggest challenge is to make people understand that the United People's Movement is not a party only for the Rehoboth Basters. It's a national party that strives to fight for the rights of all. The UPM is the voice for the voiceless. And people should forget about, no, it's only Basters. We are working from that basis, and currently we are represented, or we have branches in about 9 regions. Another challenge is that people are afraid for intimidation. So you have regional coordinators on the ground. They try their best, but as soon as you have intimidation, they will get back. So the recruitment of new members,
yes,
is not going that well.
Is that intimidation from the ruling party?
Mostly. Okay. Mostly, yeah. So, but we are looking at it. Another thing is for us to bring into the structures young people. Okay. The challenge here is that as soon as young people are involved in politics, in opposition politics, they started to become victims of all sorts. And that is difficult. So, for example, if a person is working at in a government institution, and it becomes news that now he is now also a member of the opposition, you will definitely get some problem from somewhere. Although you'll always hear that people deny this, but it's there, it's on the ground. So those are some of the challenges that we are facing.
But you are open to accepting new youthful leadership into your party?
We are open. We are open to all people.
Fantastic. Yeah.
So, and also women. Currently in our structures, we do have about 67% women representation.
Fantastic.
So we hope that we can build on that. And because I believe as a person that women, they can do better. So we would like to invite our women, we'd like to invite our youth to come and be part of the party. We will have our central committee meeting in May this year. Yeah. And then of course also our Congress in July.
Okay.
So yeah, so we are up and running, and we are ready to increase our representation on all levels, yeah.
Are there any outstanding things we haven't chatted about? Are there any issues in particular, now other than the land, obviously, issue, that you will be representing in Parliament or opposing the ruling party on?
Yeah, it's difficult to say whether we'll oppose. We used to listen and come up with some advice. Mm. And if it's necessary, then we'll oppose. But usually we will listen and we'll advise, yeah. It's also important to mention that from the side of the UPM, we accept critics. If people want to criticize us, we are listening. If you don't criticize, there's no way that we'll see this. These are the mistakes that we are making, and that we can rectify that. So we are open for suggestions and so on.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Are there any last words you'd like to leave your voters with?
Yeah, a message to members of the United People's Movement and peoples who would like to join the UPM. There are no small parties in this country. Parties can only become strong if the voters are prepared to vote for a change. And my message to voters out there is, please become involved in the election process. When the registration starts, the process starts, go and register and go and vote. Because without voting, you don't have a voice. Through voting, you can air your voice, and then you can also hold your representatives accountable.
Brilliant.
That is our message.
Thank you very much, Mr. van Wyk. Viewers, that is all from us this evening. Please be sure to SMS your comments to 555 or visit our social media pages. Good night.
Over the last 8 weeks, we have interviewed all political parties with representation in Parliament. Stay tuned for SWAPO's response to criticisms from the opposition in the following episode of One Exclusive. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube, Facebook and Twitter feeds for all our local productions. Catch One Exclusive on Mondays at 9, repeating Sundays at 6 p.m.